never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here.
Beloved, we celebrate the goodness of God as we learn His ways, His power, His grace, His favor that is working in His kingdom on the earth. And our job is to pattern our lives after this. One of the things that have surprised me in our generation is a man can receive salvation and the Holy Spirit. Some have received healing, but are not subject to the Lord where their finances are concerned. And Paul used this phrase in 2 Corinthians 9 verse 13 to further illustrate this point. He says, whilst by the experiment of this ministration, they glorify God. You know, this is an experiment. It's something they hadn't done before. The churches had never taken collection to go send to another church. And Paul was bringing them into this mystery by revelation. Maybe you've never heard from God tell you to sow a specific seed. I'm trying to bring you into it, that this is a realm you can press into, as Luke 16:16, I believe, says, that you know the law and the prophets is preached, I don't remember the first part of the scripture, and the kingdom of God is preached, that's it, and every man presseth into it. You see, every man presseth into it. You press into the kingdom, you enter into it. You determine that whatever God has for you, you will get into. And then, you know, the door opens to you. It's an experiment. So you know with time that you find yourself in places you hadn't been before. You'll be doing things you never done before by the unction of the Holy Spirit, by the revelations of God. If that is not happening, don't expect abundance. If that's not happening, don't expect any bounty. If that's not happening, don't expect any fruitfulness, let alone double. God must be pleased for there to be fruitfulness. God must be pleased for there to be abundance. And there is a righteousness that can only happen as you obey the word of the Lord. Whilst by the experiment of this ministration, they glorify God for your professed subjection. You see, your subjection unto the gospel of Christ, not the talk, your subjection unto the gospel of Jesus Christ. Don't talk it, and then when it comes to money, you run away. Don't talk it when it comes to making a sacrifice, you run away. Don't talk it. Don't talk it. God, the Bible says in Proverbs, it says that even the sacrifice of the wicked is an abomination to the Lord. Particularly when you do it with a wicked mind. He hates that. Don't hate me in the closet and love me publicly. It has to be the same. And if there are things wrong, then you know you are convicted. You have to make corrections. That's what God is pleased with. Not to live in sin and don't even think anything of it. And then people are prophesying to you that prosperity is coming. It ain't coming, beloved. Those are lies. God didn't make any such promises. Good tidings, the Bible said, go preach good tidings to the meek, people that are submitted, humble, broken before the Lord. It says, whilst by the experiment of this ministration to glorify God for your professed subjection unto the gospel of Christ and for your liberal distribution unto them and unto all men, hallelujah, and by their prayer for you, which long after you for the exceeding grace of God in you. Exceeding. You know, you see, everything is bounty. Exceeding. So prayer will be going forth. Thanksgiving will be going forth. Glory will be manifesting. Miracles will be happening. I pray that our whole church will believe this word when I preach it there and move in this direction so we can see the miracles of God, the favor of God, the power of God working. As people are touched, we believe in, you know, in a few days to, well, actually, I'm almost coming back by the time you watch this, you know. Yes, we're in Kenya, as you're watching this, ministering, teaching, taking care, you know, of all the churches that God has placed under our care in several parts of the country, meeting with our children that were in our ministry years ago in India when we were missionary there, Christian Fellowship Group. You know, it's such a joy to sow our lives and to deposit in people the things that God has planted in us through the years. It's such a miracle, beloved. It causes thanksgiving. It causes the glory to manifest. Listen to this. And by their prayer for you, they will start praying, which long after you for the exceeding grace of God in you. They long for this thing they're seeing. This blessing, this favor, this power, this miracle. You see, it's a wonderful thing when our lives reshaped by the glory. I used to be stingy and reticent and recluse and introverted. And God comes and blesses and releases. You become a giver. You're ministering. You're reaching out. I mean, people begin to thank God for you. I believe that's how you gain so much wealth in heaven. Come on, beloved. He says, thanks be unto God for his unspeakable gift. For years, I thought that the unspeakable gift referred to here, beloved, is Jesus himself. And then, but you see that within the context, he's talking about something, you know, much more reachable. I love how the living said it. Let me read it. It says, thank God for this gift. Too wonderful for words. Your gift is so precious. It's so timely. It's such a God thing. That's why I said that one of the greatest things that will happen to you in this life is to be God's answer to someone else's prayers. It's such a miracle, such a fulfillment, it's such a power, it's such a blessing. May the Lord bless you and challenge you to join us in this crusade for bounty in 2014. We love you. Let's conclude tomorrow. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.